She tried to kill my dog and steal my husband. Okay, why we? I am about to lose my goddamn mind. My dear husband and I have been together for 3 years, married for 1 year. I was forewarned by my dear husband that his mom is top-notch crazy, but she is literally blowing my mind with the level of crazy. I feel like I am in the Truman Show and this is all one big joke. Background on me: I am non-confrontational, an over-pleaser, and have a really hard time when people don't like me. And because I am so neurotic about my relationships and that I want to please everyone, I hardly ever have issues with anyone in my life. But I have multiple ulcers to prove that niceness isn't always the answer. Where to start? My dear husband is very on and off with his mom. He is her only child. They will be fine, aka him just putting up with her bullcrap, till he reaches a breaking point and then he stops talking to her. We believe she is a narcissist, definitely a bit delusional, and also heavily abusing Xanax. She has always been overly obsessed with my husband, and so in turn I am a threat. When I met my husband, he was in a really bad place and getting his life together. He is bipolar and was not getting help for it. Anytime he tried to get help or was getting better, she would do something completely destructive to ruin it because she wants him broken and dependent on her. So when I met, they weren't speaking, but at least once a year he feels guilty and reaches out to her and tries to fix it. When we were dating, I was constantly put in the middle, protecting him, but also trying to decipher her feelings because he desperately wanted to have her in his life. But she is toxic. They would get in a fight and she would immediately call me to try and tell me he is crazy and rude and try to turn me against him. Obviously, I never believed her, because I was normally there when they would get in a fight on the phone and I heard the whole conversation, and it was her screaming at the top of her lungs about nothing at all. She gives things with a shady purpose to hold it over your head forever. Anything she does comes with strings. So when we got engaged and started planning our wedding, which I won't get super into because she was horrible the whole time, but we made it a point that she was not going to pay for anything for our wedding because we wanted it to be about us and not her. We also didn't want anything held over our heads for the rest of our lives. So my parents, my husband and I paid for our whole wedding, but my mom decided she wanted to throw a rehearsal dinner, which we did not ask her for. At first, the place we were having the dinner at was willing to give us a huge discount because of how big our party was, but my mom single-handedly bullied the coordinator to the point where she told her she couldn't work with her anymore, and another coordinator was put on our party, and our dinner became extremely more expensive because of how awful she was. The whole dinner was a I love my son tribute party, and she never spoke of me at all the whole night. But I didn't care because it was her dinner that I never asked for. So cut to our wedding day. She shows up an hour late to the ceremony. So we had to start an hour late. Not one apology, nothing. And apparently she was going around to all our friends and family crap talking us through the whole reception. A year ago she showed up unannounced to our home to bring us random crap. We had a 7-month-old puppy. She hates dogs and knows we have one. She came in and we made sure the dog didn't get near her. Then she left. It was a surprisingly decent visit. She was pleasant. Cut to Thanksgiving. We are all sitting down with all my husband's extended family and my mill sits next to me. I am in the middle of a conversation with his uncle and she interrupts and says, "Your dog attacked me. I had to go to the ER and I brush it off because it's normal for her to make these crazy claims," and all I say is, "I am sorry you feel that way," because she is not rational at all. So we obviously decide to leave abruptly, and as she hugs my dear husband, she whispers, "Your dog did attack me, and your wife doesn't care at all," and my dear husband says back, "Mom, we both know that's not true," and we leave. For the next month she progressively got worse, calling almost daily, screaming about how my dog is vicious and she is going to call animal control and the police to get her put down. My husband, in one conversation when he finally got a chance to speak over the screaming, he says, "Mom, we have a baby cam in the living room where we were the whole time. I checked it. The dog didn't even get near you. I can send you the footage." She freaks out, screaming about how I am a bitch and I stole him away and that my family is perfect and he can go be with his new family, and she starts claiming my dear husband's aunt took her to the ER. So my husband hangs up, calls his aunt immediately, and she says no, she never took her to the ER, and hangs up because no one wants to upset this woman because she is like, light your house on fire, slash your tires crazy. One day she sat outside our house for 5 hours while neither of us were home, called me 102 times, my husband 180 times, and his business partner about 15 times. When I got home, I found all the gifts and things we had given her over the past 3 years sitting on our doorstep, along with a dog treat that I am 99% was poisoned. Our building has a door code, so I have no idea how she got in. It's so creepy. My husband blocked her on everything. And for the next year, she went around to his whole family saying that I am the reason they aren't speaking and that I am changing him. I am tearing her family apart. She is always the victim. She's never done anything wrong in her life apparently. So up to this week, my husband had unblocked her months ago because he felt bad and guilty, and she will call like once a month, and right when he answers it she is screaming already. She has alienated herself and is incredibly lonely because of her behavior, because she doesn't only do this to my husband, she does it to everyone. She is mean and vindictive. One time at his cousin's wedding, my mill, her niece and I were talking, and she says to her niece, "Your dad was talking about you the other day, but I really don't think I should tell you. He says he hates you and you're dead to him." Then she sat there and consoled her crying. She is a serious psychopath. I remember walking away from that and telling my husband, and both of us were so grossed out. But the other day she called and my husband decided to answer it with a glimmer of hope that she's given up this whole vendetta. He answers and the first thing she says is, "Are you alone? Because I would really like to speak to my son for once. Can we meet somewhere other than your house?" And my husband says, "Sure. You aren't allowed in my home anyway to protect my wife and my dog." So they meet up, and for 2 hours she cycles through the same sob stories. "Your dog attacked me. Your wife is a bitch. I all alone and sick and probably going to die." She fakes illnesses regularly. Then she decides to throw this curveball. "Remember when we met with your wife's family for dinner? They only talked about their other daughter the whole time. Her own family doesn't even like her," which isn't true at all obviously. She just sits at her home, alone in her thoughts, making up random crap to support her crazy narrative. It's honestly insane and doesn't feel real at all to me that she is a real person. I support whatever my husband needs to feel at peace with his relationship with his mom, but I have made it very clear to him that I don't trust her and have no plans of having a relationship with her, because she actively tries to attack my marriage and says horrible things about me when I have done nothing but be nice to her. When things were good, I was the one making sure we went to all family events, kept her in the loop with her life. Does anyone have any advice at all? I have set all the boundaries I can, but I am losing my mind slowly, haha. What happens when we start having kids? I should also add that my husband stands up for me and our marriage every time she attacks and says horrible things. He's been really great through all of it, and the fact that he sees the crazy and doesn't enable it is the only reason I put up with all of this. My family and parents have been so great and basically adopted my husband emotionally. Luckily, his parents divorced when he was really young and they both remarried, and my husband's dad and stepmom are also so supportive and great. Wow. Are your husband and mine brothers? Cause sounds like they share the same mother. Please slap me if I ever become this. I would cut her off. She sounds like a crazy person that would be a guest on the Drive Phil show. Your husband is great for sticking up for you. Also, if he has bipolar, I would keep away from her for his sake. My mill stole my jacket and embarrassed me in front of people. Was it too far? So my, not official, Mill hated this denim jacket I owned. It was denim and was that distressed style. It became kind of like a comfort thing for me and I wore it almost every day. My boyfriend's brother got engaged and had a party at a hotel. I had been online shopping right up until the day of the party and nothing looked right. Mill told me she had lots of dresses and I could choose one of hers. I liked a black blazer style one, but I got the vibe that she didn't want me to wear it and told me it was too plain, so I ended up having to wear this low-cut red bodycon dress that was light years out of my comfort zone. I wore the denim jacket over it, planning to take it off once we were inside the venue. Anxiety kicked in and I felt uncomfortable and the dress kept falling open at the front, so I decided to keep my jacket on for the time being. Mill comes over to the table I'm sitting at, with some of my BF's friends and family, and tells me to get the thing off, laughing and stuff, and I tried to say that I would eventually, but she pulled it off me and ran away and hid it. I got upset as I didn't want to be seen without it and got told I was overreacting. I have anxiety and am not comfortable in large groups, i.e. parties, and everyone knows this. They also know I'm not confident in my appearance either, hence why I liked the jacket, as it covered up what I didn't like and I felt horrible about it. I'm posting this with my BF's permission as he thinks I overreacted and just hate his mom. Also, I have to let you know that she had been drinking 2 hours prior to this happening. So if I'm understanding this correctly, she took off your clothes without permission and ran away with them? I think it's safe to say that's messed up. Did you get the jacket back? I normally don't comment on these, but this is to your boyfriend. It doesn't matter if you think she's overreacting. Your girlfriend was humiliated and upset. You need to support your girlfriend. On top of that, your mother was completely out of line. And now I'm the bad guy. Duh. So, long story short, my husband was talked into co-signing on his mother's mortgage prior to us being together. We've been together for about 3 years, married for about one. The last year and a half we have asked his mother to take him off the mortgage so we can start trying to purchase a home, etc. His mom always gives an excuse, too busy, I can't figure out how. etc. She promised it would be done no matter what by this month. Now the excuse is I'm not in the financial place to refinance. Anytime we talk about this with her, it's always me, you have to understand XYZ. I've always allowed my husband to handle it because I can't deal with it and it's his mom. Well, she called me about it today because I told her to call a guy I had been referred to handle the issue. She starts in with how she can't right now. She starts getting loud and going on about how it affects her. So I told her that we have been patient and she is now affecting the future of our family. I told her she has all the time in the world to handle it now, so please handle it. She hung up on me and then texted me that she hung up because I was talking to her like a child. She texted my husband to call her, so he called me and I explained. He was mad and they're both hot-headed, so he said he called her and they went at it. I help her whenever she needs it immediately, whether I have the time to or not. She invites us over for dinner, but always has 10 different chores we need to do for her during our time there. I'm just done and over it. I've asked for this one thing to be taken care of, but it hasn't, so I'm at my end with her. When I got home from work, my husband had flipped and said he basically crawled to his mom and told his mom that we love her, but we won't be helping her with anything until this is taken care of. So she told him she can take care of herself and will only look out for herself from now on, and now won't return his calls, which pains me to be the troublemaker now. You gotta love how some people can flip the script and manage to be the victim in any scenario. It's such bullcrap that she's stopping you from being able to own your own house. Is there any way you can qualify for a loan in your name only? Since he is on the mortgage, it sounds like he may co-own the house. Maybe he should sell it. I forget the legal term. Sell it, pay off the mortgage, split any profits with idiot Mill. She's homeless? Oops. The pandemic and the witch. Recently I gave birth to my daughter. Prior to this, the pandemic. My daughter just turned 2 months and it's been really hard on us not being able to show her to her families. We send pictures and videos constantly to my mother-in-law and my family. Prior to my daughter being born, I said that I didn't want people posting pictures of my daughter on social media without talking to me and my husband about it. My mother-in-law thought this is unfair, as it her granddaughter, not even my family does this. My husband and myself don't even post for saft reasons. Well, once the pandemic hit our town, my mother-in-law was furious I wouldn't leave my house with a newborn just to appease her. This started a bunch of posts. Yings like my son and his wife are keeping my grandbaby from me. I miss you and Nana loved you. Then came the pics. Not only was she going against my husband's and my wishes, she's spewing lies across Facebook. I know it hard being away from loved ones, but that's no excuse to attack people on social media. Well, report the photos to Facebook and then don't send her anymore if that's what she's going to do. I would say, yes, I absolutely am keeping her from you to protect my newborn daughter. Toxic mother-in-law forgets my son's EpiPen. So I need some advice on how to approach my relationship with my husband. I had to make this on a throwaway account, as H has read it as well. I saw a similar situation to what I am experiencing and thought I could get some insight. I, 32 years old female, and H, 35 years old male, have been married for 8 years, and my toxic mother-in-law has always had a say in our relationship. When I was just the girlfriend, everything was fine, but as soon as I had a ring on my finger, she has been Satan's ally through and through. She even tried to ruin the proposal H had been planning for over 6 months, but that's another story. We have a dear son, who is 4, nearly 5, and we found out a couple of years ago that he has a deadly peanut and almond, basically no nuts, allergy. I'm sure you can see where this is going. Toxic mother-in-law is a purist, as she calls herself. No modern medicine, no vaccines, etc. H actually had vaccines when he was 18, and she threw a fit when I said that she wasn't allowed to be near dear son until she was vaccinated, which to her credit she did. I asked for proof DW. Anyway, whenever we left dear son with toxic mother-in-law, lovable father-in-law has always been there. I've tried to limit contact as much as I can, but we live in the same town, only 10 minutes apart. My own parents live over an hour away. Lovable father-in-law is an amazing man who doesn't let toxic mother-in-law go too far, when he's there of course, and honestly is probably one of the main reasons my marriage has lasted, is when toxic mother-in-law goes too far, he steps in. Dear husband is their only son. They also have a daughter and she's also great. There is luckily only one crazy in this family. So the main event of this is that toxic mother-in-law grumbled the first few times she took dear son out due to us making sure that she carried his EpiPen. But I never heard more about this. Until the last time she took dear son out, lovable father-in-law was busy, so it would just be her. She had some other health issues, so I suggested that we reschedule, but H and I had a date night planned, so I relented and we left. She was to take dear son out to dinner as a grandma/grandson date, which okay, is cute when it's not her. We had just finished our main course when his phone rang. It was toxic mother-in-law, but he didn't pick up. We discussed it for a second, but decided that if it was urgent she'd call back. Then my phone rang with lovable father-in-law. Dear son was being taken to the hospital as he has ingested some peanuts and we needed to get there. Of course we left right away, and when we got there, toxic mother-in-law was crying in the waiting room. I tried to get her to talk to me, but frankly she was blubbering and all I cared about was dear son. We went up to the desk and they paged us through. Toxic mother-in-law tried to get through, but they said only parents were allowed, which probably was a good thing with what happened next. We got into the room and the doctor told us that dear son was going to be okay, and that whilst it had been a bad reaction, the restaurant had called the hospital in time. Dear son was visibly shaken up and I stayed with him a few minutes calming him down, before talking to the doctor again. I asked him if he could issue a new EpiPen to replace the one that had been used. This is when he looked down at his record sheet and said that an EpiPen had been used in the ambulance, but it wasn't ours. I thanked him and didn't think more about it. We were cleared to bring dear son home and we did. Lovable father-in-law came to pick toxic mother-in-law up, who wanted to come and spend the night at our place to watch over her baby, but H put his foot down. We left. The next morning my in-laws came over to see dear son, and toxic mother-in-law pulls out dear son's bag and hands it to me saying that they left it at home when they went out. This is when my dear son pops up with, "No Mimi, you said to leave it there." I asked her what he meant and she basically said that she had left his bag there, along with his EpiPen. I asked her again if she had really left his EpiPen at her place, and without acting shocked she just said yes. Guys, I probably could have dealt with this better, but I flew into a rage, telling her that if the restaurant hadn't called 911 in time my son could be dead, and a bunch of other names. I won't go into detail because I'm not overly proud about it. She left crying and lovable father-in-law followed after her, not really saying anything to me. I want to go and see with her for a while. She left my son's EpiPen behind, when she knows it's one of my main rules. Lovable father-in-law says that he is sorry for not being there, and guys, it's not his fault. H wants me to apologize to my toxic mother-in-law for what I said. I just don't know what to do. I know dear son was fine, but I have never been so scared in my life. It could have gone a lot worse if they hadn't been out in public. It's been a few days and I haven't spoken to either of my in-laws. I have completely blanked toxic mother-in-law and sent only a few short replies to lovable father-in-law. H is starting to act distant towards me and saying that it's my fault that his mother is so upset and that I should know better than to talk to her like that. I am thinking about taking my son and going to stay with my parents for a few days. What should I do? Tell him, would it be your fault if his son was dead? How would he be then? You should do what you need to protect your son. Remind your husband that his mother left his son's EpiPen at home on purpose. Tell him to ask her what reason she has for doing this. Also tell him to ask her how his child ate peanuts in the first place. Tell him to confirm if his mother knew his child had an allergy in the first place. The least of the answers he's going to receive is straight up neglect. If she's claiming she forgot, then remind him that that's neglect. Whether you and hubby reconcile is up in the air, but she should never have unsupervised visits again, regardless of if his dad is around. I, personally, would take major issue with a man who defends a woman who almost killed his child, just because she got yelled at. F that fragile ego. He can go nurse it for her. You keep your kid safe, cause it doesn't seem he's able to. Subscribe and turn on the notification bell for more stories delivered to you. Thanks for listening. See you later.